Good evening, everyone. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. Yeah, we got a storm coming in there at Yellowstone, and it still is rocking and a rolling. Those of you that follow me on Twitter would have seen this morning that I posted that Yellowstone is still rocking and a rolling. And being the weekend, I guess everyone at USGS just goes home, ignores the text messages that have been sent to them on their phone about earthquakes, because when there is an earthquake, the computer picks it up and sends it to somebody. There's been several minor earthquakes, but they're larger than a magnitude 2. And you'll remember Hank Hessler from USGS. Oh, what was it, about 5 years ago? He said that when Yellowstone started having earthquakes of a magnitude 2 or greater, they would become very concerned. The boreholes are still down. This monitor here is from Maple Creek. And this came in at 10:07. It is a magnitude 2.45. I'll bring it down so those of you that are watching maybe on your laptops or television can see it. It says 2.45. Let me close this out so you can see all the earthquakes marked in red. And they match up for three monitors. This is Holmes Hill on the left, Mary Lake in the center, and we have Maple Creek here on the right. Now this one here, let's open up Holmes Hill. We'll make that larger. Okay, that is 10:20. Oh, is that the one I just did? I don't know. Yeah, 10:20. Okay. All right, so I have to find the one at 10:07, which was a magnitude 2.45. All right, there it is at Holmes Hill, 10:07, magnitude 2.45. There it is at Mary Lake. And let me show you something. Yeah, it's really starting to act up. I'm hoping it's acting up because it's picking up wind from the storm that's coming in. But this is Maple Creek in the center. This is Mary Lake. And the one at the top is Holmes Hill. It's not showing that. And we'll go back another 4 hours. That way you can match up the earthquakes. See that? See how these all match up for Holmes Hill, Maple Creek. Now Mary Lake, that's quite a ways from this location of the Madison River area. These two are basically the Madison River area. So sometimes the smaller microquakes will not pick up there at Mary Lake. I'm going to show you how far it is. Going to Google Earth, here we have Mary Lake. Here we have Firehole River. Down here is Yellowstone Lake. That's West Thumb. Okay, Mary Lake right there. And then way over here is the Madison River area. Okay, this is the monitor for Maple Creek. And let's measure it to over here because this is the monitor for Mary Lake right there. Give me a second here. Almost 22 miles. Over here is Holmes Hill. Okay, again, this is Maple Creek, and then way down here is Mary Lake. Now that's the red line going to Mary Lake. And the one, let's check this out. About 8 miles. So that's the reason that they're showing up on these two, because they're closer together. This is the Madison River area, and this is Mary Lake, which is close to Yellowstone Lake. So you can match these up between these two when they're small, what they consider microquake. See it there, and I'll go back another 4 hours, and we'll pull this over so you can see all the earthquakes. Now this one here shows up on all three monitors. So does this one? All three monitors. And yeah, there's lots of them that show up on all three monitors. And I'll bring it over and then we'll go back another 4 hours because there's some larger ones. Look at that. All three monitors. Yeah, like I said on Twitter this morning, Yellowstone is still a rockin'. Look at that. And we'll go back another 4 hours. I believe that's all I pulled for so far today. Yeah, my grandson's here, one of them. Yep. This one's 6. So we got a small one there. All three monitors. Yeah, that one. See, it doesn't show up on Mary Lake because this is a microquake. That one does. Yeah, and that one does. There's just way too many today for me to go through and do them all, but I'll do a couple of them. The first larger one would be this one right here at 720. This one I really shortened up the seismic signature, and it comes in as a magnitude 1.78. I probably should have done it longer, but I didn't. So 1.78. This next one at 929 comes in as a magnitude 2.11. Go at seismic signature and I'll bring it down so you can see it. 2.11. Next one at 956. Again, this one I shortened it up really short. I should have made it longer. But it comes in as a magnitude 2.03. The next one at 1020. Now this is all universal time. And we'll go to the spectrogram. That one comes in as a 1.90. This one I already did for you. Okay, let's see. This one right here. Go to its seismic signature, and that comes in as a 1.87, but I noticed something that was really interesting. The line of melt is getting closer. Remember when I did a report, there is areas there at Yellowstone where pockets of melt, where people are walking, is only 600 feet under the ground. And that was probably from an article about 2 years ago. Yeah, 600 feet under the ground, areas where the ground is melted, pockets of melt. Now, they're saying that the melt under Yellowstone is only 5% melt in the upper magma chamber, which I do not believe. So these earthquakes steadily got smaller after the 2.45. Yesterday there was a magnitude 2.0, and what, a couple days before that was a 2.2. Anyways, let's go to this one here at 11:34. Surprisingly, it comes in as a magnitude 1.97. And we'll go to the seismic signature. Let me make that bigger. Hate that when it comes in small. There we go. 1.97. Alright, then the next one will be at 11:52. That comes in as a 1.96, and I am really shortening up the seismic signature on all of these. Yeah, on all of them I normally would probably done it longer, but just to give them the benefit of the doubt, but there's no benefit when they're not reporting them. All right, then we got another one right here, 1345. That comes in as a magnitude 1.82. And see, it shrunk down. I don't know why this program shrinks down sometimes. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Let's extract that. Yeah, harmonic tremors. Harmonic tremors. This is when magma is on the move. Let me show you. Shallow volcanic earthquakes. I call them harmonic because harmonic are about the same. They're just not as long, but we got the same signature. And sharper points would be tectonic surface events. And see, this is harmonic. Down here at the bottom and there at the top. And that's what we got here. Let me show you all three. All right, let's go to Mary Lake. We'll open that up. Let's take a look at its signature and pull the file. Yeah, see that? Let's go there. Yep. See over here on the right. That's a, oop. Darn it. Went off the line. Okay, let's pull that. And we'll go over a little bit farther. There you go. That's a real good, I made it too big. Okay, let's go over here. There, see that? Hopefully it doesn't make it too big. Well, it did. Okay, let's go up over here. There's some sharp points on there. Now earlier, yeah, we got some sharp points, tectonic, with a mixture of volcanic. Let's pull that. Okay, sharp points here, which would be tectonic in movement, and then volcanic. This here is a monitor for Mary Lake, all the way down there by Yellowstone Lake. Here's the thumbnails. I wanted to take a look real quick. I didn't download the data, but this is from Little West Thumb, which is there by Grant. Yeah, look what it's been showing. And I've talked about that for the last couple videos, how the magma's been trying to come up there at Grant. The boreholes are still down. They don't even show them here, I don't think. Let's see. Nope, they're not even showing them on here right now because they're down. And then, let's see. This is a mammoth vault. Let me bring it down. That's up there by the border of Montana and Yellowstone. Yeah, it's currently raining there at Old Faithful. And this is currently what the stream view is showing. Yeah, let's just see if I can pull this right here. Extract that real quick for you to take a look. All right, we'll make that larger. See, this here has, okay, there is rounded, rounded, sharp points, meaning we got the plates on the move. Yep. Like I said, I've been watching all day, and I really appreciate you watching my videos. Always be prepared for a disaster. If people had prepped up, stocked up on food and different things before the inflation hit, you would have been beating inflation. Not a well, unless you want to call inflation a disaster, which it is. But see, that would be another good reason to stock up, and things are just going to get higher. So better late than never. Yeah, prep up, get that food, water, medical supplies, batteries. Yeah, things that are going to start skyrocketing even more than what they are. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much for your support. Looks like we got Old Faithful going off. Good timing, huh? Yeah, I put one video up earlier of Old Faithful and one of the buffalo that were along the Snake River that was from this live webcam. Yeah. At least it's not as dirty as it was before, but it is a little dirty. Yeah, I'm going to keep watching. And thank you for watching. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you.